Amidst threats from Russia's President Vladimir Putin, the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services made a purchase that immediately had many eyebrows raising in concern. On October 4, 2022, the HHS announced that it had purchased $290 million worth of the drug Inplate from Agmin USA Incorporated. Does the U.S. government know something the rest of the world doesn't? Vladimir Putin's threats to use nuclear weapons have been met with global condemnation, but only one country has threatened to respond with, quote, deadly consequences, end quote. Should Putin move to make that fateful decision? The United States is committed to punishing Russia should it make use of even low-yield nuclear weapons in its failing war inside Ukraine. President Joe Biden, his cabinet, and the Department of Defense have all refused to answer questions on exactly what this response would be, leaving the world to guess as to what the U.S. may have planned. It's extremely unlikely that the response would be a similar nuclear attack, as the United States is committed to only using nuclear weapons in defense of itself, its allies, and those nations it has extended its nuclear umbrella to. These nations may not be formal allies of the United States, but are considered U.S. soil when it comes to the use of nuclear weapons, and a nuclear attack on them is considered a nuclear attack on America itself. This not only helps reassure nations around the world, but is meant to deter them from building their own nuclear weapons programs, thus ensuring non-proliferation of these deadly weapons. But there is one other scenario where the U.S. has reserved the right to use nuclear weapons, and that's in a first strike capacity. This doctrine is meant to discourage other nations from taking escalatory measures, including the use of alternative weapons of mass destruction, such as biological or chemical weapons, by guaranteeing a nuclear response from America. Though this is only in extreme circumstances, so the United States nuclear doctrine does not extend to the issue of Ukraine. What is certain is that a response from the U.S. to Putin's use of nukes in Ukraine will be an economic one, with America and its friends and allies leveraging their considerable political clout to completely remove Russia from the world economy. This would turn Russia into a hermit kingdom overnight, and as devastating as it would be, this wouldn't lead to nuclear war, and doesn't explain why the Department of Health and Human Services bought almost $300 million worth of medicine to use in case of a nuclear attack. That's where the second likely response by the United States comes into play, because the use of nuclear weapons inside Ukraine by Russia is all but certain to at last bring the United States into the fight. Former director of the CIA and commander of U.S. forces in Afghanistan, David Petraeus, hypothesized that a U.S. response to the use of nukes by Russia would include an overwhelming conventional attack against every Russian position inside Ukraine. This would likely involve NATO partners and be carried out via a massive air campaign launched from NATO bases in the heart of Europe. The United States has already pre-positioned B-52s in Europe, capable of bringing apocalyptic levels of firepower raining down on the heads of Russian personnel. And multiple air wings of U.S. air superiority fighters are permanently based across various American military bases in Europe. Under pressure from Ukrainian forces, Russian forces would quickly collapse under the weight of American air power. Even accounting for inevitable losses from Russian air defenses, U.S. stealth aircraft could also reach targets that Ukraine simply cannot, such as logistics hubs, lines of communication, and command and control nodes deep in the rear areas. Staging grounds in Crimea would certainly come under direct attack, and the Kerch Bridge, recently bombed, likely by the Ukrainians, would certainly be eliminated. Russia's dense S-400 and S-300 protective air defense network would be penetrated by stealth aircraft with low observable standoff attack munitions. But that's only the start of the U.S. response, as America would seek to brutally punish Russia for the use of nuclear weapons. As Russian forces are under attack on land, the Russian Black Sea Fleet would have its days numbered. A high priority for the U.S., Russia's Black Sea Fleet threatens Ukraine's trade routes due to its ability to block off ports along the southern coast of the country. It was also this fleet that made it impossible for Ukraine to ship its grain internationally, threatening a global food crisis. Now, NATO-supplied ground-based anti-ship weapon systems have given Ukraine some capability to keep Russian ships off their shores, but ultimately most of its merchant ships are unable to leave Ukraine due to the Russian Black Sea Fleet. The destruction of the Russian Black Sea Fleet would be a crippling blow to Russia's ability to project power in the area, but it would also have a massive financial cost as well. U.S. LRASMs, or long-range anti-ship missiles, are the world's first stealth anti-ship missile, a very low observable weapon designed to penetrate very dense air defense networks and deliver a 1,000-pound warhead to a ship. A single blow from an LRASM can be enough to sink smaller to medium-sized vessels, such as a destroyer if it hits it in the right place. With billions of dollars of hardware sent to the bottom of the Black Sea, Russia would not only take a massive military hit, but a financial one as well. And all that hardware would take decades to replace after tallying the effects of the current and future sanctions alongside a shrinking economy. There's no question that a U.S. response would be devastating for Russian forces, but perhaps that's exactly why the Department of Health and Human Services has proactively bought nearly $300 million in drugs designed to fight radiation sickness. Suffering such an overwhelming and humiliating defeat, Vladimir Putin would have two options: admit defeat and end the war, or escalate further with nuclear attacks against the U.S. There's no evidence that Russia is actually moving to use nuclear weapons, and it's unknown if the DHHS is buying these drugs in response to any expected attack. What is known is that the purchase was undertaken under the authority of the 2004 Project BioShield Act, which was meant to better prepare the U.S. against nuclear, chemical, or biological attack. Implate is used for both adults and children to treat extreme blood loss that occurs after severe radiation exposure. Because radiation can destroy blood platelets, small wounds can lead to huge bleeds, endangering lives. Implate stimulates the body's natural ability to build platelets, so as to rebuild the ability to clot blood and thus avoid bleedouts. It's not known exactly how many doses were bought, but it does not seem as if they were purchased to send to Ukraine in case of an escalation by Putin. Rather, this seems to be part of the DHHS's plan to keep a steady resupply of emergency medications at constant readiness. Because drugs like these often have a limited shelf life, the agency regularly buys drugs to replace those which are soon to expire, giving the soon-to-be-expired drugs back to the manufacturer to quickly sell on the marketplace. This makes procurement costs cheaper for the government and ensures a ready supply in case of emergency. The Department of Health and Human Services may simply be further enhancing its preparedness for a disaster, but the timing is very suspicious. What this means about the future of the Ukrainian conflict is unknown, but as the war drags on and Russian losses mount, the consequences of the war might end up with global and possibly even world-ending repercussions. Now go check out one of our early predictions in This Is How the Russian War in Ukraine Ends, or click this other video instead.